guys down here supporting live comedy on this cold, wintry day. Give yourselves a round of applause! Wow, well, we are just so delighted about the show that we have tonight. You're going to see some of our improv students, our level 101 and level 102 students. So some of our students that we're going to be seeing up on stage tonight, this could be the first or second time that they've ever been on stage. So we're going to give them lots of support with our hands. Everybody try it right now. And we're going to give them lots of support with our laughter. Everybody try that now. Yeah. That's mostly for me. But thank you. I appreciate that. So, thanks so much. These guys have been working really hard, so I'm really proud and pleased to bring them up on the stage. Remember, we are a little bit more crowded than usual, so make sure that you can give them a space to come up and down on stage. So without any further ado, let's get to our first game! This first game is a game called Pet Peeve Rants. And I'm even gonna, can you guys move as far upstage as possible? There you go. Yeah! Fantastic. The way that this game works is we're going to get things that make you annoyed from the audience. And our performers are going to do a little monologue off the top of their head about these topics. So I need you to start to think about things that make you mad, like the high price of fuel, or when your meal comes out of a restaurant kitchen cold, something like that. So just shout them out to me.
Open mouth chewing.
Flat tire.
Snoring.
How about from over here?
Coworker steals your lunch. Awesome.
Coworker steals your lunch.
Wet sock.
What?
A wet sock.
A wet sock. Oh, that is the worst. We need one more. This is a happy group that doesn't have any
haircuts. Parkway!
Bad haircut is what I heard. Fantastic. These are great suggestions. To review, we have...
A bad haircut.
Wait, stop.
Steelworker steals your lunch.
Snoring.
Flat tires.
Open mouth chewing.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you Pet Peeve Rants. All right, here we go. Actors, warm up.
You know, it's all quiet, it's in the house, I'm finally alone to sleep, kids are in bed, what do I hear? Oh my god, I feel like on the verge of sleep, and it's just like, oh, I'm just awake now, can't get a lick of it, it's shaking the freaking house, you wouldn't even think that's possible, but yeah, it's happening. I don't know how the kids sleep through it, we leave our doors open, it echoes down the hallway, it's a freaking echo chamber.
There's nothing worse than seeing a terrible haircut when you're sitting at work and the hair pops up from the other side of the cube. I'm trying to focus on the star ticker. Come on, some of us don't have hair. Have the decency to get a good haircut.
And so I go in to get my lunch from the fridge, and guess what I find? My lunch is gone! How could a moth stolen my lunch? Why? Why could he have done that? I can't stand nothing more than a coworker stealing my lunch. So I go and I find Mark and I scream at him! Scream!
Oh my god, wait, Socks is just gives me that. And he's just walking down the street. You think everything's going okay, and you're walking in a puddle in the water going straight into your shoes. And you're just walking, just like it's snowing now, and you walk into one of those puddles, it's dust up.
I'm on a romantic date with my husband, and the candles are lit, and it's beautiful, and it's our 10th anniversary. He takes a big bite of steak, and what do I see? Oh my god, I could see back to his tonsils. It was disgusting.
Nothing grinds my gears more than getting a flat tire. I mean, it's always when I'm going somewhere important I have to be there, like to my psychiatrist appointment, to a wedding, and then it's then and only then where I get out that manual and see how to change a flat tire. So I'm looking through, and those little jacks, I mean, I don't even know where to put them or how to use them, and it's always 40 below zero.
And then
I have a standing
desk.
I'm working. I sit back down to hide away from his haircut.
I
smell the hair pops up from underneath.
And then it's spinning.
today.
So the last time I'm changing my tire, it is 40 below.
Stink as
well. So I'm up here, pulling out your done, and I'm to the jack out. My hands are freezing, and they're about to fall off. I'm so cold, I'm hot, I'm so cold.
So at the work, I'm running on like 5 minutes of sleep, okay?
Stolen.
And then, you know, I'm faster than God wants. I got stolen headphones. I got stolen headphones. I got stolen headphones.
And that is why I can't stand flat tires.
I don't know about you guys, but I feel better. We worked on some things. So the next game that we're going to play is a game called Word at a Time Story. So our two players are going to be improvising a story for you tonight. But they're not going to do it in any old way. They are going to be doing it one word at a time. So our band of actors up here will be depicting the story for your viewing pleasure. So all we need to get started is the title of a story that's never been written, like Marvin the Marvelous Martian or Janie's First Day of School.
JoJo's Ant Farm.
JoJo's Ant Farm. Fantastic. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first and possibly last time ever, we present JoJo's Ant Farm. Once
upon
a
time,
JoJo
had
an
ant
farm.
He
loved
his
ant
farm
dearly,
but
he
had
lost
all
the ants
immediately.
He
incinerated. Until
all the ants
just
turn to ash.
Except
one
ant
survived
somehow.
This
ant
name
Chesabeezable.
Chesabeezable
went
to school
alone.
He
decided
to search
for
the dead ants.
However,
they
diagnosed
him
with anthrax.
From the audience. How about from this side of the room? We need a small animal, something this size-ish.
Chinchilla.
A chinchilla is the first thing I heard. And then over from this side, we need a sport or an activity.
Football.
What?
Football.
Football. Fantastic. Chinchilla and football. We now take you to this talk show already in progress.
Hello and welcome to Chinchilla Today. We have with us the most famous chinchilla coach in the world, Dr. Beasley.
Hello, how are you?
I'm doing very well, Dr. Beasley. I heard that you were the most famous chinchilla expert in the world.
Why, of course I am. I mean, how many of these people do you believe are here?
latest chinchilla batch to Olympic medal soccer history?
Yes, if you look right here, you can see. There they are. Look at all of these medals. We have gold, silver. That last one, I don't think that's a medal. We have all of these. They were outstanding.
Oh, they look so nice. Can I see?
Yes.
Oh, is it real?
No, it's fake.
No, but that's really good. So you have some of these chinchillas here for us?
Well, yes. Yeah, so right here, here's one. This is George. So George is, so we saved George. He was about to be a pelt, but he's good. Yeah, that's George. And then this is Sally. Sally and George.
Sally, yeah. She looks a little bigger than George. And somewhat fierce, too.
Well, so... you mention it. Sally is a little bit... It's getting a little bit closer and closer and... Oh, my God! All right, put Sally down. Sit Sally down. All right. Yeah, let's not look at Sally anymore.
Well, can you show us how your non-violent chinchilla play soccer?
Yes, absolutely. So let's put George right here, okay? And then let's leave Sally there. We'll get their kids. There's Sam. We'll put them there. Now watch. See, look at them. Oh, look! They just scored. Oh, great! Wonderful.
George is an excellent soccer player.
Absolutely. I mean, you see those little legs going? The little knees going like this is absolutely unbelievable. So, now you too. I mean, you too could have these.
I can?
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Can I have the brown one?
And... You mean Sally?
No. Georgetta,
here you go. Here's Georgetta.
Oh, Georgetta, she looks so nice. Thank you so much.
Oh, my pleasure.
Is she violent?
No, only if you feed her water.
See!
Fantastic. Chinchillas. I think it's going to catch on, you guys. I really, really do. Excellent. The next game that we're going to play is a game called Gibberish Translator. Our four players are going to come up on stage. And the way that this game works, awesome. We're gonna start by doing that. And then the next thing we're gonna do is our two players on the end, they are in a relationship, a professional relationship or a personal relationship, but sadly, they don't speak the same language. But never fear, our two translators here are going to be translating what's going on so they can have a conversation. So all we need to get our players started is a suggestion of that relationship, like siblings or doctor-patient.
Enemies!
That's somebody with an issue back there. Wow. Fantastic. So our suggestion for our relationship is enemies. Siegenheimer Schubang Song of Supergang Sang Mazuma. Siegenheimer!
I am very upset that you have decided to hurt me during Christmas time.
Blah 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 Christmas time. We're sitting together.
How about maybe the hammer chum had better have a rubble bell?
Zugan Ozer.
No.
Big Dolman Sanger, Dada
and Zappa
and
While we may be sitting together at Christmas time, your sister is not very nice to my mother.
I just love your mother.
Zip, 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 geeken, zoomen, zip, zip.
Upon further reflection, this relationship, not gonna work.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah blah.
How can we be enemies when we're in love?
My heart is full and I'd like to kiss you under the holly.
Excellent. Our next game is for all of our players. One of the things that we talked a little bit about in class, in our 101 class, is the idea of support and supporting your other players. So this is a game, an exercise that has all to do with support and taking care of your players. And it's a lot of fun to watch. This game is called Hotspot. And the way that this works is that we are going to have a player, a brave soul, they're gonna come down and they're going to start to sing a song for us, okay? And the back line, all right, let's have a round of applause. To support that person. If they start to forget the lyrics or they go astray, they're going to jump in, tap our player on the shoulder, and they're going to start a new song inspired by what happened before. All right? So here we go. Take it away, Hotspot.
Hey, where did we go? Days when the rains came. Down in a hollow, playing a new game.
Stars are brightly shining.
It is the night of our Savior's birth.
Here come the bells, there go the bell. Here are the bells, you know the bells.
I know the bells, where are the bells coming from? Who knows the song?
Gangnam Style! Wake up, grab a brush, put on a little makeup. Hide the scars and fade away the shake-up.
Why did you leave the keys on the table? Why did you leave the keys on the table? You wanted to.
Wake me up before you go, go. Na 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 na. Wake me up before you go, go.
Young man, get up.
You dream about going up there, but down there's nothing to see.
Look at the world around you, right here on the ocean.
I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars, on a collision course. I am a satellite, I'm out of control. I'm a second machine, ready to blow.
Back in that bar! Mr. Roboto, Donald.
Footloose! Footloose! Everybody cut Footloose! Scooby!
Awesome! So my one-on-one class, they're going to be heading out to the green room. We do have some more games that we're going to be coming back to do. And but we're gonna see a little bit from the other class right now. Before I bring up their teacher, if this is looking fun to you, you should come and take a class. There's signups right now for our classes next term. They start in January. We do have one level one class that's already full. So if you're interested in it, check out our website, arcadecomedytheater.com. And if a class is too big, how about a t-shirt? They make great. Thank you. Was it the t-shirt or was it what's inside? They make wonderful holiday presents, stocking stuffers. So, you know, think about that on your way out. So without any
further... T-shirts are available at the box office.
My thunder day.
I couldn't if I tried.
So without further ado, excellent. Well, I've got to tell you something. You guys are perhaps the best audience we've ever had at the Arcade. And you are so great. I want to invite you back. We have shows all weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So please grab a schedule on your way out and come back and see us. We are Pittsburgh's only nonprofit comedy theater, and we'd love to have you back. And in fact, we have some big news. I don't know if you've heard or not, but in this summer, we are moving to a brand new theater right down the street. It's going to have two stages, and we couldn't be more excited, but we need your help with some donations, coming and visiting us. Check out arcadecomedy.org, hashtag arcade upgrade. Let your friends and neighbors know. We'd love to have your help as we build our home in downtown Pittsburgh for comedy. So please check that out. Yay. Take a picture, put it on social media, tag us, and spread the word. So without further ado, I'm going to bring up our players for slideshow. This next game that we're going to play. Two of our players have gone on a trip, and they've got some pictures that they're going to share for you. They're going to tell you a little bit about their trip that they went on, and you'll just be checking out the pictures over here. So where is a fun place you might go on vacation?
Vegas.
Hawaii is the first thing I heard. So Hawaii is our suggestion. Ladies and gentlemen, slideshow.
Bruh, spring break was tight.
So hungover still.
I know.
So sunburned.
Oh my god.
Awesome.
Dude, you look so good in a hula skirt. You remember that night? Some love. No, I got some pictures from Hawaii. Do you want to see them?
Let's relive this. All right.
What's the first one?
This is exactly when my hula skirt caught on fire.
Oh my god.
I was so calm.
I like how no one's helping you.
I was so drunk at this point, I didn't even care that I was on fire.
Dude, I think it's the alcohol that made you catch on fire.
Yeah, I think you're
right. You were just like dousing.
That's why.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Then remember when we went to the hospital after that, I guess.
Got pictures of it, of course.
Yeah, duh. Oh my god. That one babe, that one nurse babe, dude. Let's look at her.
Let's look at that picture. The crazy thing is all the doctors and nurses are just staring at her. They're not even doing their job. To get treated for my fire, my burns.
Oh, she's just living in the glory.
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Oh, he's awesome. Yeah, I'm gonna go back. But
you see that nurse?
Oh, but let's check out this next picture here.
Yeah, what we got?
Oh, that's when we went swimming and we saw a shark.
Oh my god.
And we
got
a picture of it too.
Yeah, let's see that.
Yeah, let's see that picture. They still look pretty scary. There are two of them. Why are we not trying to swim? Why are we just floundering around in the water? Do you know how to swim? That's fine.
Yeah, I like how I'm not helping you either. You were fine. You were doing just fine.
Did all right, though. I made it out.
You did.
So we can take the next picture.
Dude, oh, I was tough. We were at the club. We would dance. Oh my god, do you remember? There was something with like a dragon. Do you remember a dragon?
Oh, the dragon.
Yeah,
Everyone remembers a dragon. Picture of the dragon, let's see. Oh. Everyone's freaking out about the dragon.
What are you holding, man?
I'm trying to look at the dragon and chug my drink at the same time. This is one of those weird pictures that makes noises, so you caught me squealing. There's only one picture that could top that one.
Yeah, I don't even know what it is gonna be.
Yeah, it's I forget that point.
Let's
see
just
it.
Check it out.
Oh. Wow. What happened?
I think there was like some sort of magical vision that was seen in the beyond, you know? Like we went to some sort of Hawaiian shaman. Our friend Ricky just like passed out at
He's gone. You're trying to go to the vision.
Yeah.
I think I'm puking. Maybe. I'm getting ready to puke. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Trip.
I think it was dope ass trip, man. We have such a treat for you, everyone. From their most recent TED Talk, we've brought in Dr. Know-It-All and Professor Smarty Pants. And they do have trouble with chairs, but other than that, they're super, super smart. And they can answer questions on any topic. It could be about science or sports or arts and leisure. Any question that you might have, either Dr. Know-It-All or Professor Smarty Pants can answer it. So I want you to start to think of the questions that you might have for these guys. And while you're thinking about it, I'm gonna ask Dr. Know-It-All a question. Dr. Know-It-All, Pittsburgh is such a big sports town. Do we have any championships coming up on the horizon, like the Steelers or the Pirates or anything?
It's unlikely
that
the city
will
see any
championships
from
now
to
eternity.
It's
very
unlikely
that
they
pirated
the
championships
because of
the
camaraderie
and
our
intentions.
Wow. Well, you know, they could go on and on about how we're going to be losers for forever, but I'm gonna stop it there. So do we have, just raise your hands if you have a question for one of our guests. Yes.
What are the kids doing these days?
All right. We have an old man in the audience. Professor Smarty Pants, what are the kids doing these days?
The kids.
Usually.
Eat every
thing
that we
cook.
So, all
of
our children
like
to eat
Pop-Tarts.
They're big on eating, the kids, these days. So just feed them. It's crazy. How about from over here? Yes.
How does Santa visit all the kids in one night?
Oh, the age-old question. Dr. Know-It-All, how does Santa visit all the kids in all the world on just one night?
Santa
takes
his
sleigh
and
traverses
a
great
plain
of
our
wonderful
wormholes.
So yeah, it's a Neil deGrasse Tyson thing. It's very, lots of physics. Yes, another question. Yes, in the back, ma'am.
Where do babies come from?
Oh boy. We're asking all the hard ones today. Professor Smarty Pants, where do babies come from?
Most.
Babies eat.
From
their
womb.
So, mothers
get
storks to
bring
every
Pop-Tart
to babies' mouths.
Sounds like Kellogg's has something to do with babies. So, I don't know, I guess we'll have to answer a book. So we have just time for one or two more questions. Raise your hand if you have a question. Yes.
How can we be certain anything is real?
Wow, thank you for yelling that very uncertain question. With lots of certainty, that man wants to know, how can he be sure anything is real, Professor Smarty Pants?
Everything is
possibly
unreal to
us.
I hope that answers your question! Excellent. So how about one more question, a burning question. Does anybody have one? Yes.
How do I get off the naughty list?
Uh-oh. We'll have this for both of our players. We'll start with Dr. Know-It-All. This poor young woman is on the naughty list and she wants off. What should she do?
Children who
play
badly
should
never
ever
eat
themselves
Pop-Tarts
if
they
want
to
be
on
the
nice
list.
That's one take for you. Excellent. Professor Smarty Pants, any other thoughts about how she can get off the naughty list?
Flirting with
antelope
will kill
your
Christmas Eve
cookies.
So death
is
inevitable.
Guys, as a class, one of the things that we talked about in class is the idea of characters and characters and scenes and playing different characters. So this is a game where we investigated this a little bit. We still are missing one more player. What's going to happen is our players are here in a car. They're going to be going on a road trip. And on this road trip, they're going to meet some interesting characters. And all of the players will have to adapt to the same character that gets into the car. So where are these guys off on a road trip to?
Poland
was the first thing I heard. So you guys, good luck driving to Poland.
Hey kids, can you believe that we have this amphibious car and we can go over the Atlantic? This is awesome!
Yeah, Dad, it's great!
I mean, I love Uber. This is wonderful. I mean, I can't believe the technology they brought. Hey, weird enough, there's a hitchhiker in the middle of Atlantis!
This is not the chopper! Take me if you want to live! Dad, we got to get moving now!
We got to get moving, Dad!
Get on it!
Oh my goodness!
Hurry,
let's go!
Hurry!
Yeah.
Hurry.
God,
keep moving!
No! Just
doing
it!
Moving! Oh, wait!
Shut!
What?
There's an island! I'm out!
And that is how you drive through the Atlantic! That is how you do it!
It's not the Atlantic, it's not the Atlantic. We're in the Mediterranean now.
Oh, yeah!
Let me get over there!
There's a hitchhiker!
What? I need to get to see my husband. He's in jail. Can we? What?
Soil.
Can we?
Soil.
We've only rolled down the window a little bit so we could suffer.
I'm not driving to pick up your husband again. You're jail boy. You're jail boy, Joey. But you know what? This is really starting to get on my nerves. I gotta get out of here. Shoyl, you're just bothering me.
Get out of here. You're making me mad.
We got another hitchhiker.
Oh my god. Thanks. I really gotta go to the mall because they're opening a new McDonald's, and right now McDonald's has My Little Pony toys, the kind of puppy meals.
Oh my goodness, I love My Little Pony puppy meals.
You know what, girl? I was just at Nordstrom and they had the most wonderful suit sale the other day.
I'm all right in the ocean here.
Look at your shoes, I love them.
Oh,
oh my god.
Excuse me, there's speed limits, you silly goose.
All right, I'm out of here.
Well, the kids don't have to take the wheel and drive. It's just stupid. He wasn't even wearing pink. Hey, there's someone over there. We should pick him up.
Yeah, bros! You going to the game? Yeah, bro! Yeah. Let me hop in on that! See you in jail!
Oh my god! Hurry up! Let's go!
Dude, Tipper is so hot!
Do that again! Woo! Woo! Oh, look. Oh, it's a, come on, man! Get on in!
Yo, Adrian, I didn't expect to see you here!
Yo, this bicycle bigger than the other? Because I've been switching on the curls,
can
I'm not sure.
Are you using one hand for something else?
Yes. Baking.
Baking, yeah.
Yeah.
Yo,
I'm
trying to master baking. Got a car
full before the bathroom.
Yeah, no, that's
right.
Oh man, I got a pull over for a Philly cheesesteak. Gotta go.
Narcosy cheese.
No straw there.
Poland!
Oh,
hey, look, Kabasi!
for coming out. We are so delighted that you were here tonight. We have one more offering for you, and we are going to ask both teams to come up on stage. While they're coming up, I'm going to tell you, this game is called Freeze Tag. The way that this game works is two players are going to come downstage, and they are going to be performing a scene. At some point, someone from the back line is going to say, freeze! Players on the shoulder, adapt their exact same physical position, and then start the scene in a brand new direction. Two new characters, new location, new everything. All right, it's just that simple. So in order to get started, I need two players to come on out. Now, excellent. And to get them started, let's give them a line of dialogue. Maybe something you said to somebody today.
Poland loves his pink ponies.
What?
Poland loves his pink ponies.
Poland loves his pink ponies. Did you really?
Did
you? All right. Poland loves his pink ponies. Ladies and gentlemen, freeze tag!
Poland loves his pink ponies, doesn't he?
They're so lovely. I mean, doesn't everybody?
Look how gorgeous they are.
Do you have, here's a brush. Look at the little brush on it. Look,
freeze! Can you even... Brian, I've been waiting so long to say this to you.
Yes. Yes.
We've been together for so long.
6 weeks.
6 whole weeks. I know. You're the one for me. So I gotta say, will you marry me?
Oh, why, of course.
Freeze!
You the one with the flamethrower, though?
I don't know what happened. It happened so fast, you know?
Well, take solace. They're up there.
Freeze!
Now up there, Susie, that's where I met your grandfather. In that tree, he was hiding. He had binoculars for some reason. He was looking at my bedroom. Anyways, don't dwell. He was in that tree right there.
That's so romantic.
That tree is magical. That's where I want you to meet your future husband, Susie.
I hope I find someone in a tree too someday.
Freeze! Freeze!
Okay. On the count of three, we throw the body in the ravine.
One, two, three!
Whoa! Oh, it's far!
You really gotta learn how to make peanut butter and jelly.
Can we try this again next Saturday?
Absolutely!
Best night ever?
I'll show you my family! But seriously, though. Next Thursday is peanuckle night, so I need you to make that buffalo chicken dip. If you know what I'm saying. Simon!
Yeah. I know, Billy. You need a win. You need a win. It's really hard
Freeze.
For you.
Are you ready to dance?
Of course! Let's do
it! I've been waiting for years to beat you in this dance-off.
You have been my enemy since kindergarten! But tonight, you will rue the night!
Enemy! You cannot win!
Oh, I will win! You cannot beat my moves!
For you see, I brought a rose.
Not a rose! That is my kryptonite!
Maude, I'm having hot flashes again.
Jeffrey.
Vanessa.
Amanda.
Mary Angela.
Matt.
Sue.
Mikhail.
Woo!